touched upon it a little bit, but what about the retirees? I know lots of folks retire to Arizona. I mean, do you have the 55? You mentioned the 55 and up communities in your area. What are those like?
Yeah, so they're awesome. And I keep telling my parents to move there so that I can enjoy the amenities that they have. The one in our community specifically is just, I mean, it's gorgeous. They've got golf courses. They've got these luxury homes. They've got views. They've got everything there. Golf cart living is a real thing out here in Arizona, which I never knew of or thought, you know, I thought you had to be a golfer and live on a golf course. But in the community here, everyone just has golf carts to ride around on. And so we're zipping over to each other's houses, going here and there. But in the 55 plus community, they have this such an active life and lifestyle here. They're golfing. They've got classes they're doing. They've got workshops they're doing. They're just, it's such a constantly engaged lifestyle, and they have bars and restaurants that they're all, it's packed up there. So they're not retiring here to just sit on a log and just go, okay, that was it. They come here and it's almost like this second sort of life that they live when they're here, which I love. And I know our community has an awesome one. I know Estrella Mountain Ranch, which is right in Goodyear, right around the corner from us, which is a great community as well for people who are coming from Southern California and even Northern California. If you like palm trees and lakes, that's right there. It's up on a mountain a little bit, and you have these incredible sunsets and views. They have their 55 plus community there. And then also pretty much Sun City out here is almost all 55 plus communities. So they tend to migrate in that area if they just want to be around 55 plus. But there's a lot who come to ours who maybe have grandkids or who still want to be with like a younger crowd, tend to go to the mixed communities, right? But Sun City itself is a true like 55 plus. They don't want to hear babies crying, which more power to you. I don't blame you. So there's lots of opportunities to come out here and retire and just live just an awesome active life. And that dry heat, it's great. I mean, I don't know. They love it out here.
And I know from being out there in a summer day, I mean, the mornings aren't too bad in Arizona.
Yeah, especially, you know, if you're in the shade or if you catch a breeze, and most restaurants and places have misters outside, and every place has their AC cranked up, you know, to the top. So you're it's not like you're sitting in the middle of the desert just melting with nothing to do and nowhere to go. You know, this state's been here forever. And so they've got it figured out. They understand, okay, it's almost like if you lived in, you know, back east during the winter, in the snow season, you just kind of stayed home, or you went to places, you know, that had heat and fire, right? Well, it's the opposite here. It's so hot, you just kind of stay home or go to places with air conditioning and pools and lakes. So that's kind of how we manage the heat out here.
I see. And for those folks, I mean, obviously healthcare is a big concern for lots of people, but as you get older, you certainly want access to healthcare. So what is that like in the Buckeye area?
Yeah, so Buckeye specifically, we have an emergency room within, you know, 5 minutes of us. So, you know, for that, I love that. We've got the police and the fire here that are incredible, that respond so quickly. And you've got an urgent care right here. You've got urgent cares almost off of every single exit, it seems like. But then we're also just under an hour. If you're in an ambulance going to one of the major hospitals in Phoenix, you're going to get there in like 30, maybe 40 minutes. So you've got these huge, it's Phoenix. It's a huge metropolitan. They have tons of huge, amazing, incredible hospitals. And so, and then also if you go up to that Sun City area, you're going to see a little bit more hospitals and doctor's offices and things out that way, because it's a true 55 plus sort of community. But it's not like we're lacking anything out here.
And, you mentioned that, you know, there's lots of outdoor activities. I mean, again, people out here, they say, gosh, if I move to Phoenix, I may as well just stay indoors all the time. But that's not the case. I know that. You get 8 months of the year that it's not 1,000 degrees. And even in those months where it's hot, can people do outdoor activities year round?
Yeah, so you'd be surprised, because especially if you acclimate, anything under 100, I mean, there's people I see all day long outside jogging and running and doing things, which I think is crazy. However, they're doing it. But you've got everything from horseback riding to being out on a lake and kayaking, paddleboarding, canoeing, jet skiing, boats, you know, all the water sports, you know, the everything out there, water skiing, water boarding, what is that, wakeboarding, all those things. That all happens here. You've got hiking everywhere. Just right behind us is the White Tank Mountain. So I could walk out my door and in 2 minutes be hiking up in a mountain if I wanted to. I don't particularly want to, but my husband does quite often. So it's good for him. We do go on little trails around here, but there's tons of hiking opportunities. If you'd like to be outdoors with that, there's hidden gems up here of like waterfalls and different, you know, you've got the Red Rock Canyons. You head up to Sedona, you're surrounded by red rocks. You know, if you think of the Cars movie and the Cars ride at Disneyland, they're all based on Sedona. So you go and you have this real life experience of just thousands of years of beauty all around you. And they've got a slide rock park, which is ice water that you can just jump in and swim in and hang out there all day. Hikes to hidden waterfalls, places that I've never even gotten to go yet. And I've only barely seen snippets of, because it's like the hidden gems the locals all know about. You've got to start finding them, right? And so you've got that. You've got fishing. You've got hunting. You can head up just 2 hours north of here. You're heading up and you're into Flagstaff. And now you've got pine trees everywhere. You've got 20, 30 degree cooler weather. You can hike. You can hunt. You can fish. You can be skiing and snowboarding in the winter up there. You've got full snow-capped mountains up there, driving in snow. So you kind of can get everything, every single, if you do a sport or something, you can do it here in Arizona. It's just, there's nothing we lack except for a beach. But what the beaches we're doing, we make up for it with the lakes and the nature and everything that's out here. We really, it really truly do.
You know, that's a great point. You know, I live about 45 minutes from the beach and I go maybe once every year or two. So it's not like every day I'm missing the beach. I mean, I live 45 minutes. If I live in Phoenix in a nicer home that I've paid almost cash for, I can fly to the beach and enjoy it that way.
Yeah, you definitely have a lot more money left over to actually go to like Bora Bora and be on that beach.
I think my wife would like the idea of that. Well, let's change gears a little bit and let's talk about the political environment. We touched upon the business friendliness part of it. But there's a lot of people who are concerned about things like gun rights and medical freedom. Their kids are allergic to the vaccines, and they don't want their, in California, they're being forced to make that choice of either they take their kids out of school or they have to move somewhere else. Can you talk a little bit about the freedoms that you enjoy in Arizona that you didn't get in California?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really feel like moving to Arizona, you do feel like you have freedom here. You feel it physically, like a physical freedom without like this weight of California on you, but also a freedom of your rights out here. I had someone just message me the other day about her child and not having the vaccine waiver in California, and she couldn't get this medical one. And it was just this huge, she was really distraught over it. And so I asked all my friends out here, I'm like, all right, how hard is it to get the waiver? How hard is it to do? You know, you just sign a paper. And you just say, we don't believe in vaccines, or we have issues with them, or we have a medical reason, and you just sign a paper and that's it. So you're getting into the schools here. Now, some people might not like that, but for those that need that or want that, that's what Arizona is. And that's what you're going to get out here. So you have the vaccine waiver. That's just one paper you sign. As far as the education system, there's tons of charter schools out here. You've got Montessori schools. You've got the private schools, you've got the religious schools, it's all out here. So you're not missing out, and you're not on a wait list for years. I've had friends who are messaging me saying, oh, they put their kid on a wait list when they were three and they're still waiting and the kid's 10. You know, the wait list here is there aren't any. And if there is, it's less than 6 months. I mean, it's more of just like, hold on, we'll find you a spot kind of thing. So it's such a night and day difference from when you're coming over from the mentality of waiting and lists and overcrowding to, yep, there's room, we got it, you know? And then as far as gun, Arizona is a permitless carry state, and you have a constitutional style carry. So you can carry a gun as long as you're 21 years old. I don't believe you even have to have a CCW or anything, which is kind of crazy, right? But it's been that way forever. And that's just the way it is out here. They believe in your Second Amendment rights to carry a gun. So that's how it is. I know sanctuary cities are a huge thing out in California now. Arizona has banned sanctuary cities, so you're not going to see those here at all. And it's a mostly Republican state. It's voted Republican for the last, I think, 4 or 5 presidencies. It's been Republican. So that's sort of the general, I mean, not saying there's no Democrats out here. Obviously there are. It's I want to say like a 60-40 split, but it's a very Republican, very just kind of liberal. Don't hurt anybody else and no one messes with you. You know, if you just, you do you, enjoy, live your best life and just don't hurt anybody and don't wreck the land. Clean up after yourself. That's the feel when you're here in Arizona, which is, it's a freedom that I was missing in California.
And I also assume that along with that, you're not just letting your criminals out of jail because they feel bad for them or anything like that.
From what I've heard so far, I don't think anyone's been let out of jail for any reason out here. No.
All right.